Hello all, in this tutorial we are going to solve some of the programs they have asked in Anna University examination. So the problem is this: design the HTML program for the registration of new customer to the online banking system. So customer data collected using a form after submitting the account number and the type of the account, the username password is displayed as the output. So we can use this kind of thing, or we can implement this kind of application using JavaScript. So we'll start. So I'll be creating something called HTML, then I'll be closing the HTML. So I'll be creating head section, then slash head section, then body, then slash body. So we can insert a JavaScript here. So script type is equal to text slash JavaScript, then slash script. So now I am going to create a scenario. Like I am going to create a form. So form, there will be the name, form name equal to like I can give bank. So I will be closing the form, so slash form. So I'm going to get some account information. So for that I will be giving heading like account details, then slash h1, ending that. So now I will be getting the values like enter your name, that is enter your customer name. Then we can get while input type equal to text, name equal to name, then we can put a br tag to print it in the next line, name, then we can give account number. So again we can use input type equal to text, name equal to ACC number, then br is for the next line. So we have got name, account number, then we need to get the password. So input input type equal to password. So you should not put input type equal to text, because when you type something in a password, it should not the text should not appear. So it should be the form of dot. So we have to give input type equal to password and name equal to password. Now, so as the problem asked, they have asked like create account details, which will get name, account number and the password. When you submit this form, it should display the name and the password. So to submit this form, we have to create something called as input type equal to submit. Input type equal to submit. And for resetting the form, we have to give input type equal to reset. So now we have to, before going for the next step, we will be saving this file. So I can give like validate.html. Now what we have to do is, so we have to create something. Before that, I will just check it out whether everything is correct. Yeah, it's working fine. So it gets the name, account number, password. So when I submit this, it should display the name and password. For that, what I will do is, whenever I click on the submit button, you should call the event called onClick, and we can specify the function called validateOf. So which will call the function here in JavaScript called validate. Okay, so now, so whenever I am clicking on the submit button, it should call the function called validate using an event called onClick. So what I can do is, I can go here and I can write some logic so that I can retrieve name and the password from the form and I can display it in the user. So I will be creating a variable called name, so which I am going to get it from this form. First, what you have to do is, we have to go for window dot. The name of the form is like bank, followed by the name of the control we are going to get. For example, I am going to get the name. So the name is equal to name. So we can give bank dot name followed by value. So suppose if you give any value here, any name here, it will be automatically assigned to this var name. So again, I will create something called as password. Password equal to window dot form name bank dot. So instead of name, we have to give password. Password dot value. So this is how we have to retrieve data from a form. First, we have to give window dot form name is bank, followed by the name of that control. For example, enter your name, input type equal text, name equal to name dot value. Suppose if I give XYZ, the XYZ will be stored in name. Suppose if I give the password like ABC, it will be storing in password. So now I can print here. So using the printf statement in JavaScript, like document.println, sorry, it's document.println followed by your name is followed by plus name. document.println your password is plus password. So now I can save this. Let me run, refresh this. So I'll be giving the name Arul Suju, account number 123456, and the password is like A B C D E F. So if I click on submit, so there is a problem. We need to check this. So I think there is some problem here. Function validate name window dot bank dot name dot value. So let me check. Yeah, actually the problem is it is actually displaying, but it's not visible. So what we can do is I can print some alert statement like completed. So now it will be visible to you. So I am giving refreshed, I am giving some value, and I am giving some account number. I'll be giving password ABCDEF. So if I submit, what happen is completed, then actually it's displaying. So what I can do is actually it is displayed, but it's not visible in our browser. So to show the result, instead of document.println, I have given alert. So now we will check. So I'll be giving some name, account number, then password like 123456. If I give submit, it will display your name is followed by name and your password is 123456. So the problem we have seen is, so if you use document.println in the script, so it is displaying the value, but it is not showing because it has taken a refresh. So it is not showing the result. So instead of using alert, we can use document.write. Thank you.